So here we're going to illustrate how this happens. So we have a photon here. We'll say it has not enough energy. So when it strikes the surface of the metal, nothing happens. We haven't reached the threshold frequency. But let's say we have another photon, and this one is more energetic, has way more energy. When it strikes the surface of this metal, the metal will start to emit or lose electrons. Now, how does this work in real life applications? Here's what we have is called a phototube. And this basically puts to practice Einstein's theory of the photoelectric effect. So what we're saying here is we have incoming light from photons. So they shine out and they're going to hit the surface of this metal here. And what's going to wind up happening is this metal is going to start to release electrons. These electrons are then going to hit this wire here. And this wire, we call it a anode, a wire anode. The electrons are escaping, they're hitting that anode. Electrons are just seen as electricity. So the electrons or electricity will travel down this wire to this part here called a voltmeter, which reads out the amount of energy that's passing through it. And then we're going to say here, this portion here is called the photoelectric cathode. And the cathode is positively charged. Electrons are negatively charged, so it makes sense that the electron would travel through the anode, which is negatively charged, through the voltmeter where it's red, and then deposit itself on this white bar here, which is our cathode. This generates electricity. It's this theory that Einstein used to prove the photoelectric effect.